Cabuyao City in Laguna launches a program to incentivize residents to get booster shots. Our correspondent Dennis Datu now joins us with more on the city's unique way of encouraging vaccinations. Dennis, tell us more about it.
Yes, Carmina, with the goal to encourage residents to have their COVID-19 booster shots, the local government of Cabuyao City, Laguna, has launched the Mamamayang Bakunado Bigas Ang Premyo program. Under the program, residents who took their booster shots will be given 5 kilos of rice as an incentive. According to Mayor Dennis Hain, the local government unit has allotted 100 million pesos to fund the said program. Hain said most of the residents forgo the chance to be boosted because most of them are busy working. Others also believe that having the first 2 doses of COVID-19 vaccine is already sufficient, while others still feel anxious. According to the City Health Office, 26% of those who have completed the first 2 doses of COVID-19 vaccine have been given booster shots as of August, but this number rose to 56% when the local government unit has implemented the said incentive program. The local government is aiming for 100% booster vaccination rate by year-end. They're also exploring the possibility of giving out Noche Buena packages in December to ensure that the target will be met. The Department of and Local Government has lauded the local government unit's efforts to combat COVID-19. Currently, there are only 13 active cases of COVID-19 in the city of Cabuyao. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Dennis Datu. The Filipino traveler who sparked controversy last year after skipping mandatory quarantine protocols issues an apology after pleading guilty. Our correspondent Mike Navallo now tells us more about the case of Gwyneth Chua, who was earlier given the moniker Poblacion Girl. Mike.
Carmina, a Filipino traveler who skipped mandatory quarantine protocols last December has pleaded guilty to violating a law requiring mandatory reporting of notifiable diseases and will be fined 20,000 pesos. Gwyneth and Chua appear before Judge Maureen Rubio Marquez of Makati City Metropolitan Trial Court, Branch 128, earlier today, accused of violating Republic Act 1133-2 or the Mandatory Reporting of Notifiable Diseases and Health Events of Public Health Concern Act. When asked for her plea, she pleaded guilty, according to Assistant City Prosecutor Rafael Rodrigo Esguerra. Esguerra also said that Chua apologized for the hassle she caused. Chua refused to give any comment to the media, who were only allowed to stay outside the courtroom. Her lawyers also declined to comment. However, the case against security guard Esteban Gatbonton will continue, as he earlier pleaded not guilty to the charge. Gatbonton is a security guard at Berjaya Hotel, who allegedly facilitated Chua's escape from the quarantine facility. But his lawyer, Jose Bernas, said that the accusation assumes that he has the obligation to detain. He says they believe he has no such obligation and he has no such power to detain or restrain anyone put on quarantine. Bernas added that Chua's guilty plea will not affect his client's case. Chua was with her parents and counsel during Monday's arraignment. Her parents, Alan and Gemma, and boyfriend Rico Atienza were initially included in the complaint. According to the Justice Department's press release in May, Chua's father fetched her from the hotel on December 22, 2021, while her mother accompanied her when she returned on December 25. Her boyfriend, meanwhile, was with her in a bar in Poblacion on December 23. But investigating prosecutors found insufficient evidence to charge them, along with other hotel staff. And that's the latest. Carmina?
Thanks a lot, Mike Navallo there. Back here in the newsroom, in other news, Commission on Elections Chairman George Garcia says the reason for the resignation of former spokesperson James Jimenez is deeply personal. The COMELEC has accepted Jimenez's request to avail of optional retirement, which will be effective September 16th. Garcia, however, says the move will not affect the COMELEC's fact-finding investigation on Jimenez's role in the controversial deal with the debate organizers for the 2022 elections.
Yun naman po ay hindi lamang nakasentro sa kanya, yun po ay nakasentro sa iba't iba pang mga individual at lalong-lalo na po sa proseso ng Commission Election. Kung sadya bang nagka-problema, ano ba ang naging problema, anong punot dulo, ano ang mali sa proseso, sa sistema na dapat baguhin ng COMELEC at sadya bang dapat ay may managot o kaya meron ba talagang konting pagkukulang ang ilang mga individual. So yung pong kay Director James Jimenez, siya po ay maaaring isa lamang doon sa mga kasama doon sa subject ng fact-finding investigation.
The last leg of the presidential and vice presidential town hall debates, which were supposed to take place last April, was canceled after the management of Sofitel Philippine Plaza said Impact Hub failed to fulfill its payment obligations amounting to some 14 million pesos.